There are seven important experiments that discovered DNA is the genetic material. DNA is a double helix with complementary base pairs, and DNA replication is semi-conservative. In 1928, British bacteriologist Frederick Griffith studied two strains of bacterium Streptococcus pneumoniae, a pathogenic S strain and a non-pathogenic R strain. He found that when he mixed heat kill S strain with living R strain, the living R strain became pathogenic as well. Griffith called this phenomenon transformation. It was apparent that the living R strain acquired some substance from the dead S strain that transformed it to be pathogenic. In 1944, three geneticists, Avery, McLeod, and McCarthy, repeated Griffith's experiment and isolated the transforming substance. They identified it as DNA rather than protein. There was another experiment that confirmed DNA is the substance of inheritance. In 1952, Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase experimented with T2 bacteriophages, which are viruses that infect bacteria. They label its outer protein capsid with radioactive sulfur and its inner DNA with radioactive phosphorus. Hershey and Chase found that it's the phage DNA that enters bacterial cells. Therefore, DNA is the genetic material. In 1949, geneticist Edwin Chargaff analyzed the base composition of DNA and discovered that the amount of guanine equals the amount of cytosine, and the amount of adenine equals the amount of thymine, which is now known as the Chargaff's rule, hinting at the base pairing nature of DNA. In 1952, Maurice Wilkins and Rosalind Franklin used X-ray crystallography to produce an image of the DNA molecule, giving insight into DNA structure being double helix. And in 1953, James Watson and Francis Crick deduced from Wilkins and Franklin's image and proposed that DNA is composed of two antiparallel sugar phosphate backbones, meaning that one strand runs from 5' to 3', whereas the other one runs from 3' to 5', with complementary nitrogenous bases, hydrogen bonded in the molecule's interior. The base pairing is specific, and the sequence of bases encodes the hereditary information. In 1958, Matthew Meselson and Franklin Stahl were set out to investigate the mechanism of DNA replication. They proposed three models. The conservative model results in one DNA with two original strands and another with entirely new strands. The semi-conservative model results in two DNA molecules, each with one original strand and one new strand. And the dispersive model results in two DNA molecules with patchwork of original and new DNAs. To test out which replication model is valid, Meselson and Stahl cultured E. coli for several generations on a medium containing heavy isotope nitrogen-15. They then transferred it to medium with lighter isotope nitrogen-14 and centrifuged DNA sample after both the first and the second rounds of replication. The first replication in the lighter nitrogen-14 medium produced a band of hybrid DNA, which eliminated the conservative model, which would have produced a nitrogen-15 band and a nitrogen-14 band. The second replication produced both light and hybrid DNA, which supported the semi-conservative model, and eliminated the dispersive model, which would have produced a single band of hybrid DNA.